हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी स्टैंडर्ड 10 पार्ट 1. द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट थ्रू द कंडक्टर. द एक्चुअल नेम ऑफ टॉपिक हैज बीन गिवन ओवर हियर, दैट इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. लेट्स स्टार्ट. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर लर्निंग थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट. वन इज इफेक्ट और एनर्जी ट्रांसफर्ड इन इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट. सेकेंड, हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. एंड थर्ड, मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. सो इन प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड यू हैव डिस्कस, यू हैव लर्न सम कंसेप्ट ऑफ अबाउट द करंट. सो वॉट इज दैट? यू हैव लर्न द कंसेप्ट ऑफ स्टैटिक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, ओके, एज वेल एज यू हैव लर्न हाउ द निगेटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल्स ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन ऑब्जेक्ट टू अनदर ऑब्जेक्ट, दैट मीन्स द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स और पॉजिट्रॉन्स, ओके. As well as you have learned the concept of electric current, that means what exactly it is, what is the SI unit of that. In this chapter, we are going to learn a very important concept, that is effect of electric current through the conducting wire. That means we are learning how the current is flowing through the conductor, what exactly the potential difference concept, what is the effect of resistance of the conductor, and what are the applications of this electricity. Also we will discuss about heating effect of electric current and magnetic field produced because of electric current. So in today's session we are learning the first concept, that is effect or energy transferred in electric circuit. As you can see in these pictures, okay, we are having this so many appliances. All these appliances are working on electricity. But the question comes to our mind that which effect of electric current do you find in this? This is what? A simple circuit. This is the rotations, that means the energy, electrical energy get converted into mechanical energy. Here in electric bell, the electrical energy gets converted into sound energy. So let's discuss about how the energy is transferred in electric circuit. To understand this concept in more detail, let's think some materials like connecting wires, electric cells, electrical resistance, voltmeter, ammeters and plug key, okay. And let's see about this circuit diagram. We are having a battery over here. As you can see, the battery has been given, which is connected across the resistance R, that means AB, which is the conductor, or which can be considered as any appliance, okay. Like suppose let us consider that AB is the electric bulb. Now capital A is the ammeter and capital V is the voltmeter, as well as capital I indicates current flowing through the circuit. Now this symbol is the symbol of key, that means it's a switch. Let's try to understand this concept, how the current is flowing through the circuit or through this conductor AB or any appliances or a bulb through this animation. Let's discuss about the basic circuit, which includes bulb and the battery. Now we are having the connecting wires also. When the one terminal of one connecting wire is connected to positive of the battery and other connects to the any terminal of the bulb, and the other terminal is connected to negative of the battery and the other terminal of the bulb, then the bulb will glow. So that means what? The circuit gets completed here, right? This is called electric circuit. That means actually it is the path along which electric current can flow. So this is the actual circuit diagram in animation, which we can draw, that the current is flowing through this bulb. That means actually the electrons are flowing through this bulb, through the wire, okay, because of the battery, because of the potential difference created across the bulb. Now the electric current means the flow of electron in one direction. Here we should remember that the electrons are always coming out from the negative terminal of the battery, and it is flowing in this manner through the bulb, and then it reaches to the positive of the battery. Then we can say that the circuit gets completed. This is called as electronic current. That means the current is flowing because of the flow of charges or flow of electrons. In that same direction, the energy is also transferring, that is negative terminal of the battery to the positive of the battery through the bulb. So this is the exact direction of transfer of electric energy. Electric current means the flow of electrical energy through the circuit. Now with the help of the circuit diagram, we are having a battery which is connected across the two terminal A and B, that is what simply a resistance, that means simply a bulb, and there are two devices which measures the current, that is ammeter, and voltage across AB, that is voltmeter. So we have given the name voltage is VAB, that is what voltage across AB. Now if in a circuit the resistance is replaced by the motor, then in which form will the energy given by the cell get transferred into? That is the question for you. You give the answer. P be the electrical energy. Let us consider that P is what, the electrical energy. So electrical power is defined as the rate of change of energy with respect to time. That means how much energy is transferring through this any appliance, that is AB, and in how much time it is what flowing. So that is what the simple ratio of electric power. So it is energy is nothing but what, voltage into charge. That means how much potential difference we have been created across that AB and how much charges are flowing through this, through it with respect to time. So we can say that Q upon T will be the current, which you have learned already in last year. So the equation will be V into I, or VAB into I, that is what electrical power. If I is the current flowing continuously through the circuit, then the heat is produced in the resistor in time t, and that will be H is equal to P into T. This is the basic formula of heat energy. So the formula of heat energy will become voltage into current into I into T. So that means VIT will be the formula of heat energy. Now according to Ohm's law, we know that V is equal to IR, that means voltage across AB is equal to current into resistance, and by using this formula we can write the three different equations of heat energy, that is H is equal to V square AB into T by R. Second, H is equal to I square RT, and third, which we have discussed, that is H is equal to VIT. Then what is the unit of electric power? We know that power is energy upon time. That means energy means joule and time means second. So it will be simply joule per second, right? The unit of the power is joule per second, but this electrical power explained concept by the scientist, watt. So that's why the actual SI unit of the power is watt. Now these are only the formulas have been given in this chapter. So whatever problems will ask at the end of this chapter, it will be based on these concepts only, that is electrical power as well as heat energy. So you should remember these three equations of power and three equations of heat energy. Let's discuss the second point, that is heating effect of electric current. When a resistor is connected in an electrical circuit, heat is produced in it due to the current. This is known as heating effect of electric current. So what is happening, as a common experience, that whenever the current is flowing through the coil or the current is flowing through the conductor, then that conductor gets heated somewhat, and this is happening because of resistance in a conductor. So let's see this concept of heating effect of electric current with the real life examples. You have seen these appliances at home in which the electrical energy is converted into the heat energy. This is simply the electric toaster, in which the coil has been heated and the bread becomes toasted. इफ यू सी द बल्ब इट्स अ नॉर्मल बल्ब विच इज कनेक्टेड अक्रॉस द बैटरी एंड द स्विच देन द बल्ब कंसिस्ट ऑफ द टंगस्टन कॉइल विच इज बीन हीटेड बिकॉज ऑफ द फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड वेन द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट पास थ्रू द मेटेलिक कंडक्टर द कंडक्टर गेट्स हीटेड एज इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज ट्रांसफर्ड इन टू द हीट एनर्जी एंड दैट इमिट्स सम लाइट एनर्जी ऑल्सो. लेट्स सी सम मोर अप्लायंसेस अबाउट द हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. इलेक्ट्रिक आयन, रूम हीटर एंड स्टोरेज वाटर हीटर. एज वी नो दैट इन इलेक्ट्रिक आयन देर इज अ बेस इन विच द कॉइल इज देयर एंड दैट कॉइल गेट्स हीटेड बिकॉज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट बेस बिकम्स हीटेड. द सेकेंड इज रूम हीटर इन विच द कॉइल इज देयर एंड स्टोरेज वाटर हीटर. दैट मीन्स अ नॉर्मल हीटर विच वी हैव सीन नॉर्मली इन द बाथरूम. सो दीज आर सम अप्लायंसेज विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन विच द हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज हैपनिंग. दैट इज दीज आर द हीटिंग एलिमेंट्स. फॉर गेटिंग हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट वी शुड रिमेंबर दिस इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स. दैट इज द रेजिस्टिविटी शुड बी वेरी हाई ऑफ दैट कंडक्टर. सेकेंड high melting point and third negligible variations in resistance due to temperature changes. The best example for low melting point heating effect is a fuse, electric fuse. This we are using to save our appliances whenever the fluctuations are happening. Same way we can use the fuse box or the fuse wire also. Now what is happening? An electric fuse is a safety device used to protect the electric circuit against the excessive current. Now whenever the currents becomes very high in the fluctuations, then this wire, fuse wire, gets melted and the appliances get saved. That is the most important use of fuse. An electric fuse contains a fuse wire that is designed to withstand a particular amount of electrical energy flowing through it. Whenever the current is flowing through this fuse wire, then because of the melting point, high melting point, the fuse wire gets melt and it breaks the connection, so that the high current which is flowing through the this wire will save the appliance. There are different values of this fuse, like 10 ampere, 6 ampere, etc., depending upon the field where we are using and the appliances in which we are using. In all electronic circuit, we are using the fuse of different values. Now, this is the exact concept of Joule's law, that is, the amount of heat produced in a conductor is equal to the product of, means multiplication of, amount of current square, the resistance of the conductor, that is capital R, and the time for which the current passes through the conductor. That is what simply the Joule's law. Here the small explanation has been given. How can we get the equation H is equal to I square RT, which we have already discussed, okay, in a previous part of this topic. In this explanation which we have discussed, they have given the three important formulas of power. That is, power is equal to voltage into current. Second, power is equal to V square R upon R, that means V square upon R actually. And the power is equal to I square into R. And in this explanation, they have been given the SI unit of the power, that is watt, and the simple conversion in between the actual SI unit of power and the energy joule. That means the unit of energy, joule. We will use this conversion to solve some problems on this topic, because as I have told you that the questions, that means numericals, have been asked always on this topic only. So that time we will discuss this conversion more detail. Thank you so much.